welcome back to our channel. I was just finishing up shooting a couple of footage for our gray water recycling system that we're gonna upload on our other channel, the Clean & Week one. But I'm gonna use some of the footage to make this video as well. But I wanna quickly share a story why we want to have a gray water recycling system in the first place for this house. When we first talk about building and designing a sustainable house, we knew that we want to have some kind of a system that really managed the wastewater in our house. And not only the wastewater, but we also want to have a system that we can, you know, integratedly harvesting the rainwater and then use that rainwater for other purposes around the house. So that was like the main idea. And then Aldi, my husband, his background is actually environmental engineering, and then he also for the last 10 years worked for sanitation department in our national planning agency of Indonesia. So his work revolved around urban water, sanitations and hygiene. So he literally one of the few people that can talk a lot about shit legitimately, and it really helped us to create the system because he understands the technicality. And then when we have these specific ideas, we pitch that to our contractors and the people who design our house, and this is the system that they came up with. So we're pretty happy with how it turns out because it works really well so far. We did have some glitch here and there in the first few months, but we finally able to figure that out. One of the reasons that we want to have this system in place is because when I learn more about facts on water, it really scary. You know, if you read it from the United Nations website about water, you'll see that there are a very few sources of water left available in the world, and water scarcity is a real problem. There's million people that don't have access to water these days, and even Jakarta, the city that I'm currently living in, we do have a lot of problem with waters. I mean, we only have two seasons, right? Dry season and then the rainy season. And every year in Jakarta, during the rainy season, it always flooded everywhere. It shows that we have a real problem on how to manage our water, right? And in addition to that, Jakarta as a city is actually sinking because people has been withdrawing all the water inside the ground. That makes the ground level sink. So the way we actually use our water at home really does have an impact to the environment. So we really want to make sure that we try as best as we can to minimize that negative impact to the environment by implementing this system. So that's the whole idea. And you know, learning about those things, it really give me an anxiety, because there's one thing about pandemic that, you know, you can try to be at home, wear a mask, all that stuff, but then like if you don't have a clean water running in your home, what are you gonna do? I mean, it's scary, right? Because water is such an important part of our lives, and for some people that are lucky enough to have access to that water, sometimes it's easy for you to take it for granted, while other people in other parts of the world really struggle to get clean water and fresh water. So apart from the gray water recycling system that we're going to show you in this video, we actually also have a few other features that we implemented around the house to help us save water. So I'm gonna show you one simple tricks that we did for our parents' house, which is, well, not exactly in the municipal house, but in my parents' house, which is next door, that I think can be very simple and everyone should be able to do it. So here you go. So this is the rainwater harvesting system that we built for our parents. This is our parents' house, by the way, and this is the municipal house. So if you can see, the system is quite simple. We just put a giant water tank here that has a pipe that connects to a water gutter that we place on the roof. So during rainy time, the water will fall through this gutter and then gets inside that water tank. Simple, right? Then we have a water tap to open the water. And quite recently, we actually upgraded the system to add some water pump. So we place a pipe along this line, and then we have this small jet pump over here, then place another water tap over here so we can use it in this area.
So this is the simple rainwater harvesting system that we created for our parents' house. The water that we collect in here is actually quite enough for us to water the plant around this area. We also use the rainwater that we harvested here to clean up the cars, for example, or cleaning up around the area that is outside of the house. We don't use this rainwater to, you know, clean up dishes or laundry or anything like that, just for anything outside of the house. So we have another water feature that is interesting in our house, which is this one. So this is actually our garage. And that's our compost, by the way. The old garage that we have in our old house doesn't have a material that can absorb the water. So we wanted to change that and making a garage that can actually absorb water during rainy time.
Okay, now let's talk about the gray water recycling systems that we have in the responsible house.
Okay, so where do we begin?
So it happens actually in this very area, let me show you. All water from level 2 and level 3 of our responsible house gets collected in this pipe and it goes there,
mm-hmm.
It goes here. So okay. What's happening here is that all the water gets collected and it's passed through this grease trap,
mm-hmm.
And goes through the filter system. This thing filters all the water. And then it goes to this ground tank, gets collected, and then water from the ground tank, uh-huh. Gets pumped through this filter. Uh-huh. So we have the second filter, uh-huh. Goes up to the reservoir in our rooftop.
Okay.
From the rooftop, the water gets distributed to all toilets in the house.
We do also have a rainwater harvesting system as well, right?
Yes. The rain harvesting system is just like the water gutter on the rooftop, and it gets collected through the same pipe as
okay.
I mentioned earlier.
And then put it in here.
Yes.
And then basically, if I can summarize what you just mentioned, all the water that we use to flush our toilet is basically the water that comes from here, right?
Yes. The recycling system collects the gray water and rainwater.
What is gray water again?
Gray water is water that we use to wash our body, hair, dishes from kitchen sink and from the bathroom. So the gray water contains a lot of organic material from, you know, skin shed,
oils,
food, some scrap foods that might get into the system. And the content in the gray water makes water stink. We thought that the filters can actually solve that issue. But then actually it doesn't. After consulting with some wastewater experts, we decided to have an upgraded system, which is we add this feature here. You see that? That's actually a pipe going from the first filter to the ground tank. So this feature adds some chlorine. We have that approximately a few-ish weeks ago. And then we found out that the water flushed in the toilet very stink of chlorine. So we decided to remove a bit of the chlorine. The experimentation here, it's okay now. It's rather okay. It's not. It doesn't have a foul odor. It doesn't stink, but it doesn't also stink of chlorine. So we'll see what happens because it's just like 2 weeks. We'll update you on that.
So that was the water feature at the Minisponsible House. I hope you find this information useful and interesting. And if you ever decided to create a similar system or you already have one in your own home, please do share it with us in the comment below because I'm really interested to see what's your take on this. And hopefully, because the holidays coming up, we can create more videos and explain other features in our house. I know some of you already asked about our solar panels and other features. Hopefully, we can upload those video that explaining all that very soon on this channel. So subscribe and follow along our journey in living in a sustainable house. Thank you guys. See you.